was in the town of Jacksboro in 1873. A man by the name of Prego came walking up to me, saying, "How do you do, young fellow? And how would you like to go to spend the summer pleasantly on the range of the buffalo?" Well, being out of employment, to this Crago I did say, "Whether or not I go with you depends upon the pay. If you pay good wages, transportation to and fro, most likely, sir, I'll go with you to the range of the buffalo." "Well, yes, I pay good wages and transportation too. If you're agreed to work for me till the season's through. But if you get disillusioned, head back to Jacksboro. Most likely, sir, you'll starve to death on the range of the buffalo." His manner being persuasive, he soon filled his crew again with some 10 or 12 in number of able-bodied men. The trip, it was a pleasant one, as lengthy journeys go, till we crossed Peace River on the range of the buffalo. There our pleasures ended and our troubles all begun. A lightning storm came over us and made the cattle run. We got full of the stickers that on the cactus grow. And the outlaws waited to pick us off on the range of the buffalo. Buffalo hump to eat, and hard-old sourdough bread. Strong coffee and an alkali water to drink, and a cowhide for a bed. The work was hot and gruesome, as any skinner well would know. The mosquitoes found you soon enough on the range of the buffalo. All been too extravagant, now he could not pay. We had squandered all the profits, he had nothing left to show. So we left Prego's bones to bleach on the range of the buffalo. Crossed over Peace River, and homeward we are bound. No more in that damn country shall ever we be found. Home to our wives and sweethearts, tell others not to go to that godforsaken place, the range of the buffalo. God-forsaken place, the range.